So this week on the channel, we're going to be taking a look at an ink from Robert Oster. Now, before we take a look at the color, let's touch on a few things with the bottle. It's not a bad design by any means, and the fact that we're getting 50 mL of ink for a good price is nothing to sneeze at. I mean, hey, they even put a URL on here. And I do agree that with RO, you definitely do get enjoyment, variety, and trust. So that's a good thing. But I feel the bottle just lacks that substantial feel to it. Maybe if it were glass or something. Anyways, we're here for the color, and this week it's the Penchley exclusive Antelope Canyon. Now, having written with this ink for about a week and a half, I can say that the sticker is pretty spot on, which, come to think of it, tends to be the case with most of the RO inks that I've tried. So now that we've gotten the preview, let's get this uncapped, inked up, and on paper. In a little bit of a switch up, let's look at the dry time first. This is one of the more perplexing dry time sets that I've had in a while. On Tomoe, we were fine nib dry by 20 seconds, but what happened on Rhodia? Sure, I switched up from dot pad to blank, but nothing else changed. So why we are all the way up to 30 seconds is beyond me on this one. But that is something to keep in mind, because it was repeatable over the entirety of last week. Now, looking at our color potential, this is what I like to see in an ink blot. Before we even start writing, we know this ink is going to give us a good dynamic from medium light to honey, and all the things in between, including a nice burnt orange. There's not really anything resembling sheen presenting itself here, but that fade to black is really nice, and I find this to be a more soothing orange than some of the other ones that I've tried. So let's start on Rhodia. As a few of my commenters have pointed out, I write pretty slow, and this Moonman T1 flows more like a medium than the fine nib that it is, so we're going to get more of the darker medium tones. But you can see, in the few parts of my writing where I do pick up the pace, that the lighter shades do make an appearance. Overall though, with how lubricated this ink is, and with the dry time anomaly that we saw earlier, Antelope Canyon seems to prefer a more bold look. That's not necessarily a bad thing, but with what I saw in the ink blot, I kind of feel let down here. When it comes to oranges, I use them so infrequently that I need a little more dynamic to keep me wanting to use them. And on Rhodia, that's just not here. And switching over to Tomoe seems to yield the same results. We're still getting a bold line that's more in touch with the darker parts of the bottle label and the ink blot up top. Now, quick aside, I do think this looks like the Antelope Canyon in northern Arizona. Well, at least it looks like that when the sun is hitting the canyon just right, and nature bumps up that saturation curve for you. That, and you happen to not look at the strips of tan and white running through it. But hey, for a company that's not based in Arizona, let alone not even based in the US, I think that Robert Oster got it spot on. Now, the last thing we're going to look at today is the water resistance. I honestly didn't know what to expect here, as I didn't do a dry run with the ink before filming. The lifting already had me suspect of the overall performance, with nothing good normally coming from that. But once we got it dried off, the result was better than expected. We had a good ghosting layer that made it recoverable, even though we're still miles from being waterproof. So putting the opinions sprinkled throughout this video into a common thought, I'd say that if you got this ink when it came out, you probably agree that you made a good purchase. One day, I'd like to see Robert Oster come out with a glass bottle, but I know I'm probably in the minority there. As far as the performance from this ink, I was thrown off by the dry time anomaly, but I feel the ink made up for that in color and flow. The darker oranges are really nice and kind of remind me of Garfield. And hey, with it being an RO ink, you know it's going to be very well behaved. So TLDR, if you have it, awesome. But if you don't, ask a friend who does to send you a sample vial. It's an ink worth picking up in one way or another. But that's going to be it for this video. Don't forget to ink up that subscribe button, become a patron for early releases and extras, follow the channel on Twitter and Instagram, and remember, don't drink the ink.